Today is May 4, 2021, and today we will have something called as a freestyle presentation in the first 30 minutes. And after July 3rd, 2020, Dakshit has rejoined. Welcome, Dakshit. Welcome, Dakshit. So, Dakshit was part of some sports session way back in the month of October, and after that, he's making his way on the trip. So, as far as the presentations are concerned, Dakshin Siddhar, Mitra, Kalpita, Sidhi are the ones who are going to make presentation as a town. So we will see the presentations. So we will have the first presentation. Every presentation will be holding a presentation time of 8 minutes or 8.5 minutes and then about 3 to 4 minutes questioning sessions. So each individual will have 12 minutes, not beyond 12 minutes. If you are elongating the presentation beyond 12 minutes, your CRS might get affected. This time management is very important for a professional presenter.
Okay. Sir, if our presentation
alone
lasts for around 12 minutes, then there will be no minus
answer.
Without
the question and answer will be taken off.
Okay.
If you want the presentation to be elongated, the question and answer will be taken off.
Okay, sir.
So the question and answer with the presentation, this entire package widely will fetch you proper benefits in CRS.
Okay.
Okay, right? It is like scoring 99 and getting out. It is around 99 and seeing 100 of the sentences, this was 0 of the other. At least one question should be there. One question and answer should be there in order to call your presentation as a full lesson.
Okay.
So, Vishnupriya wanted to make a presentation. And she has the most stable mind in the entire planet.
25
hours. Huh? The CAA person number. Upper Nelson Mandela person number. Upper Sir, Kenya Bundle Delhi. Upper Nessa and Nalak Pandra. So the presentation is cancelled. So we will have Aswatthaman, the first person to go to the stage to make the presentation. Dakshit, they will make presentation. All you have to do is once they finish the presentation, you have to ask some questions. That's the activity today. Neither you are physical activity, the football, the hockey, the mind. Any gas was scheduled now. But since you have come, we will have some physical activity downstairs. Maybe two or three presentations. And our presentations are done and so on. But you have to go to the
school.
In this evening session, the sports is going to be done.
We need to get a soccer and things are funny.
Soccer is an integral part of MS.
Okay, sir. At least for now.
The color is born out of the
Yes, sir.
ஓடுறீங்க கஷ்டப்படுறீங்க கிரிக்கெட்டில் வந்து எனக்கு கிடைக்குது
சார் ஃபீல்டிங் கிடைக்குது சார் கிட்ட நான்
வர மாட்டேங்குது
நான் மெம்பர்ஸ் இல்லாதனால
அது பாஸ் ஐ ஹவ் டோல்ட் யூ ஆ வீக் இஸ் 3 டேஸ்
சார் அது ஓகே சார்
அதுல யார் என்ன அப்போசிஷன் நீ ஏன் திருப்பி தொலை பேசுறீங்க starts 3, 2, 1, go.
Only the person who had this
question for Ashwatthama.
Yeah, Ashwatthama, your presentation is really great. Now my question is, speaking of the story which is narrated to us, really good story and it's a must learn for everyone. And my question to you is, have you experienced something very similar to what the friend lying down experienced in that story? Have you experienced some good friend of you beating you? Have you experienced it?
It's not been a big betrayal, but many kids who travel from places might have some sort of discrimination like that. So once a friend near me, he was wanted for my things. At least he helped me at least to play the game. I had bat, I had ball, I had everything which he doesn't have. At least he made me feel better to stay in the game. What he did was he forced me to play a game in Android. What he did was, he said I don't want this because my mother would not allow me to do it. So what, let's give a shot, he was asking. So what I did was, he misguided me that side. So,
What was your emotional reaction when such thing happened?
This time I did not realize anything, but my mother restricted me too much to hang out with him because he has been seeing his language, his body language, everything. So when I stopped being with him, I realized what he's doing to me and why.
In a span of 9 minutes and 30 seconds, we did a very good presentation. Let's see how far this is going to contribute in the credit rating system of Ashwatthama. The topic was really nice. Very admirable. So it's Ashwatthama's turn finished, and now we will have Milind
Balaji.
chieftains and other sort of people started rising up against the British. let's not go too far. Let's not go towards north or east or west India. Let's start from the south. In fact, let's start from Tamil Nadu. We had a ton of freedom fighters who started their work even before 1857. And today we are going to be talking about some of them. Freedom to India came at a price. Some of the freedom fighters died. Some of them lived in jail. Some of them were, you know, subjected to a lot of torture and humiliation. Let's talk about some of them. Let's start from Tamil Nadu. And the person which I'm going to speak about is Pavo Vaidya. Let's say this table, let's simulate this table as the British Empire. If you want to, let's give it a person. Let's imagine that this table is a person and he represents the British Empire. If you want to ask for the table, who are the most strong, like most incredible tacticians or incredible generals which you have faced? If you ask this question to the British people, they'll say only two names. Two of their toughest opponents in India. One will be Hyder Ali, which is well known to everyone, and another is not well known to everyone. It's Mardan Ayyam or Muhammad Yusuf Khan. In fact, he is from Tamil Nadu. He was one of the most difficult and threatening rulers that the British ever faced. Let's talk about him. Muhammad Yusuf Khan was born as...
You have Dheeraj Chandra in your list.
Yes, sir. Second. So Mardan Ayyam was born, Muhammad Yusuf Khan was born as Mardan Ayyam Pillai, but then due to some unknown circumstances, he converted into Islam. No one really knows why. Some say that his parents died when he was young and a Muslim doctor raised him up. And this is the most believed one. Well, some also say that since there were a lot of Nawabs in South India during that time, they might have forced his family to convert. But most probably it's the first one. Let's talk about the journey of Mardan Ayyam or Muhammad Yusuf Khan. He initially joined the French. He went to Pondicherry. He wanted to become a soldier. Actually, he was born in an agricultural family. He did not want to become a peasant. He wanted to become a brave warrior. He wanted to become someone who the world would look up to. So he joined the French army. And then he absolutely humiliated any opponents that came in front of the French army. He defeated the British quite a lot of times. He slowly, from the rank of a soldier, he rose up to a clerk. But then he had some issues with the French government. He felt that he was not getting properly respected. So he left the French army and he joined hands with the British. At that time, there was a person called the Nawab of Arcot. He ruled a major part of Tamil Nadu. His aim was to make friendship with the British and to enjoy it. He did not want, he was ready to do anything to satisfy the British. He just wanted money. So he joined the army of the Nawab of Arcot, and there he showed brilliance. He rose up to the level of a major in the army. He controlled the army, started controlling the army. All the British authorities started to, you know, laud him for his contributions. Muhammad Yusuf Khan then fought a lot of wars for the British. Actually, he fought for the British. So you might be wondering why I'm mentioning about him right now. But then his attitude changed slowly. One day what happened was, in Madurai, there was one queen named as Meenakshi. I'm not talking about the goddess Meenakshi, she's different. And this Meenakshi is different. So Queen Meenakshi was ruling over the kingdom. Actually, her husband died due to some unexplained circumstances. And she had an adopted son. But the British, as usual, they don't accept adopted sons as the legal rulers. So what happened was, the actual father of the adopted son came and revealed all the truth to the British. He said that they are putting my son as the king. So he is not the legal heir to the throne. So he can go and capture Madurai. So Muhammad Yusuf Khan leads the charge and he enables the British to capture Madurai. And Queen Meenakshi is arrested. But after that, what happens is, the Nawab of Arcot decides to build a mosque after demolishing the temple. The Meenakshi temple. That's when slowly Muhammad Yusuf Khan starts realizing how evil the British are. He starts realizing that we must not, even though he was a devout Muslim, he started realizing that we must not force our religion on someone else. Yes, sir. And then he opposes the British, he gathers around 400 soldiers, and then he establishes his own kingdom in Madurai. And then no one could enter Madurai during this time. He joins hands with the French again. Well, as Rani Lakshmi Bai. So Vela Lakshmi, her husband was killed by the British. But then what happened? was she fought against the British after 8 years, and she reclaimed her kingdom. The British never dared to attack her again, and she died as an independent ruler. So this is a great achievement, and it should be respected as much as we respect Rani Lakshmibai. So these were the three people who I was going to talk about today. So thank you everyone for listening. Have a great evening. Look, I carried out an experiment. I went to my grandmother and asked, "Grandma, what do you know about Pulitzer?"
Pulitzer.
Sorry, sir. So she said, "He was a great ruler, but he was not as good as Veerapandiya." But the thing is, Pulitzer was the only person who was able to defeat Muhammad Yusuf Khan when he was in the British Army. Muhammad Yusuf Khan lost to Pulitzer once, and only after that he was able to catch Pulitzer. And even then he was not able to successfully deal with the British. Pulitzer escaped through successfully. Just like Pulitzer, there are a lot of unsung heroes in the Indian history. In any field you pick, there are only some names who are celebrated and some names who are not celebrated. So I just wanted to make sure that even the unsung heroes get some sort of...
Speaking about Veerapandiya Kattabomman, he was a thief and a robber.
Yes, sir.
He was not a conqueror. I don't have him in my good books, but he's... Just because Shivaji has acted in a very big legendary movie, that doesn't make Veerapandiya Kattabomman a very big legend, in my books, in my opinion. But I am pretty much interested about Maradhan Sarbodhar.
Yes,
the Maradhan brothers, very brother and Chinnamma.
Yes.
They are actually the real epitome of the warrior attitude.
Yes.
Cinema Rathani Karma.
Yes.
Why do you think, like Pulitzeran from Netrittan Seval, Netrittan Seval, Pulitzeran,
yes,
part of the wood,
yes,
Pulitzeran, Veeran Chinnamalai, then Veeran Achaiyar and Maradhan Sarbodhar, why all these people were curtailed after, beyond a certain extent, barring Maradhan Ayyan's story that he was spoken,
yes,
why these people, holding up lots of, recent archaeological report by Maradhan Sarbodhar, a body collection,
yes,
skeleton collection. The skeleton is pretty an archaeologist. Archaeologist stands 6 feet and 2 inches tall. Archaeologist, he's from Germany. And that is only 6 feet 2 nikkirare. Maradhan Sarbodhar, very Maradhan, skeleton or Pulitzer nikkirare. Our every Pulitzer nikkirare. Inge our Pulitzer kirade, Maradhan Sarbodhar, our phone. Upon that short name is in Paris. And that is Jai Jai Nikar. British Ellarne Padini of Nauru, Haikata. But physically, on the dominant Panda in that, all these people. Why do you think these people were biting the dust and they were not really elevated in the history? What could be the reason?
Sir, I think, according to my opinion, sir, some of the movies also play an important role. Sir, Veerapandiya Kattabomman had a movie on him. Rani Lakshmibai had a movie on him, sir. I think Kangana Ranaut acted on the film. And even one person called Narasimha Reddy, he even had a movie on him, sir. But these people, despite the fact, even the Marudu brothers, sir, they defeated a tiger, sir, in order to save one of their kings. So it shows that they even are ready to sacrifice their life for their king, sir. So it's impossible to imagine what, how much their tendency to sacrifice would be for their whole country. So I think some journalists, some parts of the media and some filmmakers have to bring this issue up, and they have to make them as much popular, sir. Veerun Achaiyar's contributions are at par with Rani Lakshmibai, according to me, sir. So I think more people must start realizing it so that it may possible.
We did not have proper messengers to carry the news to the deserving people who wanted to know the knowledge of these people. We only had British broadcasting which didn't carry any message about the Indian warriors. They only spoke about the East India Company's achievements. Ancestors of Terizilanda and the news only to our forward from our other generation. That's all it is.
And also about these kinds of unsung heroes, we are not getting that into most of the history books, sir.
Yes.
And instead, about Veeran Achaiyar also, I studied in 6th standard, sir. That is 2018, sir. That was not in history book, but that was present in Tamil books.
Tamil books, yes, sir.
The Tamil books, sir.
Yes. That's right. So in any case, I really appreciate you for taking up this wonderful topic. The presentation went for about 40 minutes. Sorry?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, the time moves.
Okay.
And that's all it is.
Yes, sir.
Our question get an hour question.
Okay. Two enough.
Two enough.
Okay.
Time?
Yes, sir.
Anybody else has a question? Yes, sir. There are the question cake on the middle.
Yes.
Yeah, nobody knows. Okay. Thank you. Don't worry, you don't lose it.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So we have two more presentations pending. The presentation Monday and Eki, then I come. Any Pandu? Any other?
Mechanic.
A senior presentation. Now, I'm going to write it. I'm going to call mechanic. So, I'm going to call it. அதனால் என்ன டாபிக்னு கேட்டப்போ எங்கள் அப்பா மெக்கானிக்கு எங்கள் பேப்பா மெக்கானிக்கு எங்கள் அண்ணன் மெக்கானிக்கு அதனால் மெக்கானிக்கு பற்றி கேட்டு ஸோ வி வில் மேக் அ குயிக் ஆன்சர்
ஃப்ரம் யூ நான் அந்த மெக்கானிக்
கேட்டேன் கேட்டேன் இவர் சின்ன வயசுல ரொம்ப ஆசைப்பட்டு என்னோட வாங்கினா அதை வந்து பெரிய சட்டம்
வாங்கி மெக்கானிக் கேம் பற்றி அவர் பேசுறேன் கார் மெக்கானிக் பற்றி
பேசுறேன்
So we will make a quick format change from Dheeran Chinnamalai, then Varadhanayagam and Mohammad Yusuf Khan. We will come to mechanic. See you.
All the best.
All the best.
Ready? Don't it?
Then you tell me if you should be now. You know? 5 minutes. You want to go out?
Yeah. 5 minutes.
5 minutes. T-shirt will carry it in and
mask. Mask.
Mask.
Remove your mask. Stand like a soldier. Speak louder. Prove that you are least to none. 3, 2, 1, go. Last question, Sipika.
Okay.
Sitra, Vishnu, Priya, Kandita, Dakshin. Yeah. We'll start with Vishnu.
Okay. So, Sipi, you have learned about mechanics. So what inspired you from what you have learned about mechanics?
So which, what is the experience that you had for the night?
step out of the house. And though I think I have wasted a lot of time in those times, but I did not have anything to do, and I did not think of these skills also. But now I have prepared a schedule, and it was because I read a book which was called As Time Is Not Infinite and 12 Principles by an author. And that is where I started preparing the schedule for myself and started practicing it. The one thing I get is a complete satisfaction when I go to my bed that I have accomplished all the things that I had in my to-do list. And now I have started to not procrastinate things. I don't postpone things tomorrow. I do it now. This is the difference I see from this last 10 days. Now
very good presentation. My question was, some people dream about manipulating with time. Like, for instance, let's say a time machine is invented, they think that they could use it and it could go to the past, and they could be lazy and they could rectify their mistake by using the time machine. I have two options for you. If you had the power to manipulate time, yet will you do it or not? Yes or no? If yes, will you go up to the future or to the past?
And I would like to stay in the present itself now. If I am as a person before MS initiation, or if I am as a person before the last summer vacation, I would definitely say I would like to travel to the future now. But now I want to see what is happening in the present now. When you go back in the future, you already know what has happened, and when you go back